was that for a story, huh?
I actually found it quite wholesome. Malu reconnecting with her family in the mainland, getting to see her father's 300ZX before turning it over to her, and just building relationship bridges between her American and Hawaiian heritages. Honestly, it was pretty cool.
Well, I'm glad you guys enjoyed it, because it's now time to see just what Malu has done to her car.
And she's done a lot to it. Power-wise, not much has changed. But in terms of handling and visuals, there was a lot that was done. First and foremost, the car now has better grip and nitrous power, as it's able to put more power down and corner far better than the other two 300ZXs. More specifically, the car now loses a lot less speed in the corners, so much you'd think it's uncanny. In terms of visuals, the car is unique all the way around. It features its own wide-body kit with a unique front bumper and splitter, carbon fiber hood with unique sleepy eye pop-up headlights, Rofo 5-spoke custom rims that are white in the front and pink in the rear, a unique rear spoiler, lots of aftermarket decals, and a Hauheli pinkish blue vinyl that stretches to the rear right bumper of the car. Inside, the car sports a racing steering wheel, new bucket seats and seat belts with four-point harnesses, a unique multicolored Hawaiian necklace or lei hanging from the rear view mirror, and a unique Hawaiian-themed shifter. Oh, and did I mention that this car is technically a roadster? Malu managed to remove the car's glass roofs. So this car is basically an open-air targa-top tuner in all its glory.
This car looks absolutely unique and is free to earn at any time, unlike the Kaido-ou, which is a Summit exclusive. Anywho, let's check this car out. I'm kind of excited to see how it does.
We'll be right back.
Is a massive improvement. Look how far ahead it is in comparison to the other variants of its kind. I'm curious as to why they made that car so terrible to drive, but so good to tune, customize, and look at.
It's still a bit of a mystery. The 300ZX was one of the main cars that I wanted to get my hands on in the first American Legends. But I was left really disappointed after testing it. Then came the Kaido-ou during that unique Japanese live summit. And it was even worse. Leave it to Malu to make the TwinSeater twin-turbo Z32 finally properly drivable. I don't think it's a well and true competitor compared to some of the fastest of the class, but it's no longer a definite pushover.
So, redemption?
Redemption. The 300ZX is no longer the worst of the Fairladies, thanks to Malu. And I just hope it stays that way when we head to Hawaii for the Motorfest.
As do I, my friend. Let's end things here and prep for our next review. And if you loved what you saw today, with the 300ZX now being a more competitive, more admirable tuner, then you know what to do. Leave a like on the video and subscribe to us for even more action. On behalf of my colleagues, Striker and Transporter, this is Atomica, getting ready for a new world of speed on Transporter FM. We're about to welcome an even faster Bugatti onto the channel, so stay with us. We'll see you in a bit.